So this is the first clinical trial to test whether Verapamil can have beneficial effects in patients with new onset type 1 diabetes. Verapamil is a calcium channel blocker and used as a blood pressure medication for many years, but it's also been used for other things such as migraine headaches. We have previously shown that Verapamil can prevent diabetes in mice and even reverse diabetes, overt diabetes, suggesting that it may have beneficial effects in humans as well. In this first trial, we will recruit patients 19 to 45 years of age that have been diagnosed with type 1 diabetes within the last 3 months. And while continuing to receive insulin treatment with their insulin pump, they will be randomized to receive either placebo or Verapamil for 1 year. We will measure their ability to produce insulin and their blood sugar control, as well as their C-peptide response to a mixed meal as an indirect measure of their own functional beta cell mass. Unlike most type 1 diabetes trials, it does not include the use of any immunosuppressive or immune modulatory medications, which often have very severe side effects. Rather, it is based on a well-known blood pressure medication that has been used for 30 years, Verapamil, and therefore is unlikely to have any of those side effects. It is also targeting the patient's own beta cell mass and insulin production, so it's very different from any therapy that is currently available for diabetes. And finally, it is actually backed by a lot of strong mechanistic data in different mouse models as well as in human islets that suggest that this approach should work, and also knowing the mechanisms behind it. We initially discovered TXNIP in a microarray study using human islets, and we found it to be very strongly upregulated by glucose. We then went on to show that diabetes also induces TXNIP expression in beta cells, and that TXNIP promotes diabetes-associated beta cell death or apoptosis. With that in mind, we studied deletion of TXNIP, genetic deletion models of TXNIP, and were able to show that those mice were completely protected against both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. We and others have shown that TXNIP deficiency or inhibition of TXNIP have beneficial effects in other organ systems affected by diabetes, such as the heart, the kidney, and the eye. Most recently, we found that TXNIP also regulates beta cell function and insulin production, and that the inhibition of TXNIP actually promotes insulin production. So even a small amount of surviving cells, when TXNIP is inhibited, would be able to produce more insulin than with a higher level of TXNIP. Once we've shown that genetic deletion of TXNIP can prevent diabetes, we obviously were interested in finding a pharmacological tool that we could use to inhibit TXNIP, because obviously when patients come to the clinic, they typically have already the diagnosis or have already the symptoms of diabetes, and we don't catch them before they develop diabetes, so preventing the disease would not necessarily be an option for humans. We wanted to have the ability to reverse the disease rather than to prevent it. We therefore started studying different compounds and found that calcium channel blockers, and especially Verapamil, was capable of inhibiting beta cell TXNIP, and went on to do in vivo studies in mice with it. We first confirmed what we had seen with the genetic deletion models, demonstrating that oral administration of Verapamil was able to prevent diabetes. But then we went on and took it one step further and tested mice that had already developed overt diabetes with blood sugar levels over 300 milligrams per deciliter and started the Verapamil treatment only at that point, and found that again, Verapamil was capable of reversing the diabetes, and those mice became normal glycemic. And the reason for that was that they were able to maintain functional beta cell mass, and the beta cells were able to survive. Well, it obviously would be great if we would see the same thing, namely reversal of the diabetes or significant reduction in the insulin requirements of the patients receiving Verapamil in this trial. We don't expect necessarily such a dramatic effect, especially not in a study that is that short with only 1 year duration. We don't expect a complete reversal of the disease or any significant effects like that. However, it has been established that even a small increase in the patient's own beta cell mass and function can have dramatic beneficial effects in terms of outcome, blood sugar control, and also long-term complications. And this is most likely due to the fact that our own beta cells are much more able to respond adequately to very fine fluctuations in insulin demand, much more so than would be possible with insulin injections or even with the insulin pump. Being a truly comprehensive diabetes center made the study even possible, and that's due to the fact that we closely collaborate bench researchers as well as clinic physicians. And so obviously that is a great plus. In addition, we're able to draw from the resources offered by the Center for Clinical and Translational Science, or CCTS. And then even more importantly, we have a very active ongoing collaboration with the Alabama Drug Discovery Alliance and Southern Research Institute, and are in the midst of a drug development program to develop new small molecule highly specific TXNIP inhibitors. And so with the background that we have with the previous molecular studies and this clinical trial, we're hoping that once again we'll be able to make the translation from the bench to the bedside.